After a bit of a shaky start, Irvine muscles his way through, ball into the middle, and it's creeped in. That will go down as an Elkan Bagot's own goal. Takes a touch off the defender. No help whatsoever for the keeper there. Unfortunate way to concede, but Australia have the lead. Long to go before the break. It's a slender 1-0 lead. Lovely ball in, and there is a second for the Socceroos. Martin Boyle. Great delivery from Jones, and no one picking up Boyle at the back post. Two-goal cushion now for Australia. Back heel into the path of Atkinson here. Jackson Irvine unmarked. Great save from Ardie, but he can't keep out the second. Craig Goodwin. The second-half substitute with his fourth international goal. Australia lead by three now. That might just wrap things up. Australia might add another. Great ball in, great header. Harry Suter, the Leicester City player, with his 11th international goal, rises above the rest, and a glancing header makes it four.
The ball's high into the box for Tajikistan. Jirabayev, the defender who's up in the area, stands up the cross into the middle, and Hanonov heads Tajikistan into the lead. The two centre-backs combine, and it's a wonderfully well-taken goal after half an hour. Khalid Erisa gave it every... Maybe one last chance for UAE. It's played in, and Al-Hamadi wins the header. United Arab Emirates level the game so late in the day. Al-Hamadi got there ahead of Hanonov and knocked it in. Time, penalties it will be. It's Caio Canedo for the United Arab Emirates. Saved by Yatimov. Advantage Tajikistan in this tense shootout. Canedo couldn't do it. Now the 21-year-old Shukurov for a place in the quarter-final. Shukurov has held his nerve for Tajikistan. The dream run for the debutants continues onwards. Elation for the whole time. Iraq looking downfield, but it's given away quickly. Al-Naimat, he's got the pace to beat the defenders. Can he keep his cool in front of goal? You bet he can. That is a tremendous chip finish. He sat the keeper down, a Jordan strike in first half stoppage time. And you know what? They're good value for the lead. Another break is time to slip away. They're going for the leveller. It's Jassim's corner, and it's headed in by Saad Natik. The simple set piece is the key in the end for Iraq, and they're back on level terms. It had been coming, and it is game on once again here. Natik, the defender, getting up high. Doski is free on the left for Iraq. His cross is only glanced on towards Ayman Hussain. What a finish! And Iraq have turned the game on its head. Incredible scenes here. Hussain has scored, but his celebration has been deemed over-exuberant. He's got a second yellow card. Iraq down to 10 men, but in front. Incredible. It's Ulwan's cross, headed back to Nizar Rishdan in the D. Oh, penalty shout there, maybe. Al-Tamari picks it up. Still going for Jordan. Oh, the shot saved, but the rebound will be turned in. Al-Arab was there to finish it, and the penalty claims won't matter for Jordan. He stayed onside, and it's 2-2 deep into stoppage time. Iraq could not hold on. Jordan have the man advantage. They're not thinking about extra time just yet. Ratib gets it back to Nizar Rishdan. Iraq's title hopes are suddenly in tatters, and Jordan have surely won this. It's an Asian Cup classic. More efficient. Gifted there to Ode Dabah. Two defenders with him. Dabah goes all the way himself. He took them both on, and he beats the keeper for good measure. Wonderful work from Ode Dabah, and Qatar can see for the first time at this tournament, and it is a problem of their own making, to be honest. Not much time left in the half. Afif's corner, it's met in the middle, and it's in for Qatar. Al-Haidous the scorer, and Qatar are back in business. The movement from Al-Haidous was top draw, and what a time for Qatar to get this back to 1-1. That is literally the last kick of the first half, and we're level at the break. Movement on and off the ball here for Qatar. Afif's ball into the middle for Almaraz Ali. He was surely brought down there. Penalty kick Qatar. a massive moment for the home side. Al-Haidus has just given this to Afif, and Afif keeps his cool from the spot. Straight down the middle he goes.
Last minute of play here. Lovely ball, great control, and what a goal that is by Turgunbayev. Kalmatov picks him out, still had work to do. Puts it through the keeper's legs after lovely chest control to bring it down. Uzbekistan, the first team to score against Uzbekistan with a one-goal cushion at the break. Thailand need a reaction. So much better second half from them so far, and they have their equaliser. It's the substitute, Subhachok Sadashat. And what a goal. Picks that bottom right corner out beautifully. Look at the bend on that effort. Uzbekistan will feel hard done by after their first half performance. Now on level terms, back in the lead though. Great solo effort there from Faizulayev. Back to goal as the ball comes in from Masharipov. He's able to turn through the legs and into the bottom corner. Well, no real chances at either end throughout the entirety of this first half. Now perhaps Saudi Arabia off the crossbar, again, and then just wide. Well, hardly any chances so far, and then three all in one go for the Green Falcons. How did they not score there? One change for Saudi Arabia, Abdullah Radif. Here's Radif on the ball now. Radif finds the bottom right corner, and what an introduction for the Al-Shabaab striker on the pitch for 34 seconds. And Saudi Arabia have the lead thanks to their number 20. Into injury time now. Surely Saudi Arabia have done enough, or have they? Off the crossbar, Cho Gui-sung on as a second half substitute. 9th minute of stoppage time now. Here comes the delivery. It's headed back across the face of goal, Cho Gui-sung. Can you believe it? Korea with an injury time equaliser again. Twice in the group stage and now in the last 16. Go to a penalty shootout here. It's a coin flip to see who moves on to the quarterfinals. So Kharib needs to score here. Jo Hyun-woo with one save already, and he's got another. Back-to-back stops from the Korea Republic keeper. Hwang Hee-chan, the Wolverhampton Wanderers striker, with a chance to send Korea Republic through, and he hammers it into the top right corner. Korea Republic leave it late again. It's been a really, really strong start here from Samurai Blue. Decent ball in, and a fantastic save there by Ibrahim Lutfala. And the Bahrain goal. And looking the more likely to find the breakthrough here. Maikuma with a rocket off the woodwork. Doan with the follow-up. Japan with the lead. It was a thunderous strike from Maikuma. And fell kindly to Doan, who was first to react. And slots it home from a close range. Japan with a deserved lead. That really dominated things. They've won the ball back inside the Bahrain half. It's given away cheaply. That is not the ball you want to be playing. Japan with a second, and a second that will count. Japan in complete control here. Bahrain need a way back into this now, perhaps, and they have a ticket back into the game. It's an own goal by Ueda. Confusion between Ueda and his goalkeeper Suzuki. And the ball bobbles over the line. All of a sudden, Bahrain are right back in this. And even after conceding, yet again, has to be said, Japan still looking like the better team here. Another chance and another goal. It's Ueda who makes up for that own goal just moments ago by slotting it through the keeper's legs. Ibrahim Lutfala unable to keep it out. Half an hour gone. Again, Yunan coming forward. Taremi's gone down. Ayham also with a push in the striker's back, and it will be a penalty for Team Melli. Taremi with a chance to give Iran a lead. A lead they would deserve, and a lead they have under their... And the great corner, Azmoun with the header. He could easily have a hat-trick already. Sadar Azmoun has cleared off the line brilliantly. Oh, beautiful ball over the top from Hurbin. It's Sabak. Sabak goes down. Beyran Vant with the foul. He's only been on the pitch for 2 minutes, and Sabak has won his country a penalty. What a moment for Omar Hurbin to level things up here. Cool as a cucumber. The man with the... We head into a penalty shootout. Iran lead 2-1. Fahd Youssef for Syria. Beyran Vant with the save. Guesses the right way. And it's not the best penalty. Chance now for Ehsan Hagi Safi to send Iran through. And he hammers it into the top right corner. Team Melli, hold on.